हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम रेडियोग्राफर मोहम्मद बूटा। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज़ कंट्रास्ट मीडिया यूज्ड इन रेडियोलॉजी। कंट्रास्ट मीडिया आर हाईली डेंसिटी एजेंट्स यूज्ड इन डिफरेंट रेडियोलॉजिकल प्रोसीजर्स। दीज शोज़ एंड आइडेंटिफाई द एनाटमी एंड पैथोलॉजी ऑफ ऑर्गन्स वेल। कंट्रास्ट मीडिया आर ऑफ टू बेसिक टाइप्स, इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट मीडिया, ओरल गैस्ट्रो इंटस्टाइनल कंट्रास्ट मीडिया। इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट मीडिया। इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट मीडिया आर यूजली गिवन इंट्रावेनसली एंड आर यूज इन वेरियस फ्लोरोस्कोपिक कंट्रास्ट स्टडीज, सीटी स्कैन, अल्ट्रासाउंड एंड एमआरआई। दीज कैन आल्सो आउटलाइन द यूरिनरी ट्रैक्ट और बाइलरी ट्रैक्ट डिपेंडिंग ऑन द रूट ऑफ एक्सक्रीशन। कंट्रास्ट मीडिया आर यूज इन एंजियोग्राफीज, इंट्रावेनस यूरोग्राफी, हेपेटोबाइलरी कंट्रास्ट प्रोसीजर्स, अल्ट्रासाउंड, सीटी स्कैन एंड एमआरआई। इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट मीडिया आर यूजली यूटिलाइज टू आउटलाइन द वेसल्स एंड गिव इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग वेस्कुलैरिटी ऑफ एन ऑर्गन और मास लयन। इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट मीडिया यूज इन फ्लोरोस्कोपी एंड सीटी स्कैन। इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट मीडिया आर हाई मॉलिक्यूलर वेट आयोडीनेटेड कंपाउंड्स। द आयोडीन एटम कंटेंड इन दीज कंट्रास्ट मीडिया मेक देम रेडियो ओपैक ऑन रेडियोग्राफ, फ्लोरोस्कोपी प्रोसीजर्स एंड सीटी स्कैन। इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट मीडिया आर यूजली क्लियर एंड ट्रांसपेरेंट सोल्यूशंस एंड इट इज़ द ड्यूटी ऑफ रेडियोग्राफर टू चेक द एक्सपायरी डेट ऑन बोतल and carefully look for any turbidity or cloudiness of solution. In case the solution is turbid in appearance or expired by date, it should be discarded and not used for patients. These are basically of two types: conventional ionic hypertonic contrast media or high osmolar contrast media or HOCM. Newer non-ionic iso-osmolar contrast media or low-osmolar contrast media or LOCM. Conventional ionic hypertonic contrast media or high-osmolar contrast media or HOCM. These are conventional older iodinated contrast media which are hypertonic with osmolarities ranging between 1200 to 1500 osmoles per kg water, approximately 4 to 7 times osmolarity of blood. Toxicity of these contrast media is more because of their high osmolarity. These cannot be used in subarachnoid space. Examples: urographine, newer non-ionic contrast media, low osmolar contrast media or LOCM. These are newer iodinated contrast media which are isotonic and iso-osmolar to human blood. Due to low osmolarity, iso-osmolarity of these contrast media, toxicity with these contrast agent is very low. Can be used in subarachnoid space. Examples: iopomidol, iopomeride, ultravest. Advantages and disadvantages of non-ionic low osmolar contrast media over high osmolar contrast media. Advantages: more comfortable arteriograms and IV injections for patient, less tissue toxicity, reduction in number and severity of adverse reaction, can be used intrahelically. Disadvantage: relative disadvantages is high cost of non-ionic low osmolar contrast media comparative to low cost of high osmolar contrast media. Intravascular contrast agent in ultrasound. गैस माइक्रोबबल्स इन अ सॉल्यूशन आर द बेसिक फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ अल्ट्रासाउंड कंट्रास्ट मीडिया. अल्ट्रासाउंड कंट्रास्ट मीडिया आर यूजुअली इंजेक्टेड इंट्रावेनसली. दीज आर हेल्पफुल टू विजुलाइज द ब्लड वेसल्स ऑन अल्ट्रासाउंड एंड आल्सो वेस्कुलरिटी ऑफ डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स और मास लाइंस. एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ अल्ट्रासाउंड कंट्रास्ट मीडिया आर इकोवेस्ट, लीवर वेस्ट. इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट एजेंट इन MRI, पैरामैग्नेटिक कंट्रास्ट मीडिया. पैरामैग्नेटिक कंट्रास्ट मीडिया गिडोलिनियम यूज्ड इंट्रावेनसली काज शॉर्टनिंग ऑफ TI रिलैक्सेशन टाइम एंड प्रोड्यूस्ड इंक्रीज्ड सिग्नल इंटेंसिटी वाइट ऑन T1 वेटेड इमेजेस. इनहेंसिस द पैथोलॉजिकल लेयर एंड शोज इट वेल. सुपर पैरामैग्नेटिक कंट्रास्ट मीडिया यूज इंट्रावेनसली काज रिडक्शन इन T2 रिलैक्सेशन टाइम हैंस प्रोड्यूसिंग डिक्रीज सिग्नल इंटेंसिटी ब्लैक ऑन T2 वेटेंट इमेजेस. एडवर्स इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट मीडिया यूज इन फ्लोरोस्कोपी. इंट्रावेस्कुलर कंट्रास्ट मीडिया मे लीड टू मैनी कॉम्प्लिकेशंस विच मे बी वेरी माइल्ड टू लाइफ थ्रेटनिंग रिएक्शंस रेंजिंग फ्रॉम स्लाइट नोजिया टू इवन डेथ. द मैनिफेस्टेशंस ऑफ एडवर्स रिएक्शंस टू इंट्रावेनस कंट्रास्ट मीडियम आर म्यूकोकुटेनियस रिएक्शंस दैट इज फ्लशिंग, पैलर, रिनोरिया, अर्टिकेरिया एंड इन द मोस्ट सेवर केसेस एंजियोनिरोटिक ओडेमा. Onset may be immediate or delayed up to 3 days. Nausea or vomiting, headache, sneezing, arm pain, locally due to perivenous injection or due to stasis of the contrast medium in the vein, less common with LOCM. Thrombophlebitis and venous thrombosis, abdominal pain, rigors, bronchospasm, predisposed to by a history of asthma and concurrent therapy with beta blockers. In most patients, the bronchospasm is subclinical. Hypotension usually accompanied by tachycardia, but in some patients there is bradycardia. The latter is rapidly reversed by atropine 0.6 to 2 mg IV. Hypotension is usually mild and is treatable by a change of posture. Rarely it is severe and may be accompanied by pulmonary edema. Hematological changes. Blood microviscosity is increased and pulmonary hypertension may be exacerbated. Sickle cell crisis may be provoked. Slugging of skin secondary of extravasation of contrast medium, less common with LOCM. Convulsions, especially in patient with an epileptic tendency and in patient with cerebral tumor undergoing CT. Convulsions may also occur secondary to the cerebral hypoxia caused by hypotension plus minus cardiac arrest due to arrhythmia, ischemia secondary to hypotension or coronary artery spasm during an anaphylactoid reaction. Contrast induced nephrotoxicity, anaphylaxis, life threatening complication. It is clinically manifested by severe breathlessness, bronchospasm, glottic edema, circulatory collapse, shock, abdominal cramp or diarrhea. The patient may die unless immediate and appropriate resuscitative measures are taken. Oral or gastrointestinal contrast media. Gastrointestinal contrast media are usually given orally to outline the gastrointestinal tract and are used in fluoroscopic guided barium studies and CT scan. These are of the following main types: barium sulfate suspension. positive contrast medium used in fluoro-guided procedures and CT appearance white and radio opaque on radiograph CT scan. Water-soluble contrast media gastrographin, positive contrast medium used in fluoro-guided procedures and CT scan, appears white on radio opaque on radiograph. Water, negative contrast medium used in CT scan, appear hypodense to soft tissues on CT. Gases, that is carbon dioxide and air. Negative contrast medium used in fluoro-guided procedures appear black on radiograph. Let's study in detail. First, barium sulfate positive contrast medium. Barium suspension is made from pure barium sulfate. It is a high density compound which are radio opaque and thus outline the gut very well. Particles of barium must be small, 0.1 to 3 micromole, and a non-ionic suspension is used to prevent clumping. Examination of different parts of the gastrointestinal tract require barium preparations with different properties. Barium, for example, barium swallow need 250%, 100 ml or more as required. Barium meal 250% with water 135 ml, a high density low viscosity barium is required for a double contrast barium meal to give a good thin coating that is still sufficiently dense to give satisfactory opacification. Barium follow through 60 to 100% with 30 ml, 300 ml, 150 ml is performed after a barium meal, small bowel enema, 1500 ml, that is 60%. Barium enema 115% with 500 ml or more as required. Advantages. The main advantage when compared to water-soluble contrast agent is the excellent coating which can be achieved with barium, allowing the demonstration of normal and abnormal mucosal pattern. Low cost. Disadvantages. The barium spills into the peritoneal cavity. There is a high morbidity associated with barium peritonitis. After barium administration, subsequent abdominal CT are rendered difficult to interpret due to artifacts. Patients may be asked to wait for up to 2 weeks to allow satisfactory clearance of the barium. If possible, it is advisable that the CT be performed before the barium study. Complications. There are many complications of barium. First, perforation. The escape of barium into the peritoneal cavity is extremely serious and will produce pain and severe hypovolemic shock. Despite treatment, which should consist of IV fluid, steroids, and antibiotics, there is still a 50% mortality rate of those that survive. 30% will develop peritoneal adhesions and granuloma. Intramediastinal barium also has significant mortality rate. It is therefore imperative that a water-soluble contrast medium is used for any investigation in which there is a risk of perforation. Aspiration. Barium is aspirated is relatively harmless. Sequelae include pneumonitis and granuloma formation. Physiotherapy is the only treatment required for both aspirated barium and LOCM and should be arranged before the patient leaves hospital. Intravasation. This may result in a barium pulmonary embolus which carries a mortality of 80%. Water-soluble contrast medium, positive contrast medium, that is gastromyro or gastrographin. Indication: suspected perforation, meconium ileus, to distinguish bowel from other structure on CT, a dilute solution of water-soluble contrast medium, for example 50 ml of gastrographin in 1 liter of flavored drink, is used so that minimal artifact shadows is produced. LOCM is used if aspiration is a possibility. Complications: pulmonary edema if aspirated, not LOCM. Hypovolemia in children due to hyperosmolarity of the contrast medium, drying fluid into the bowel. Allergic reactions due to absorbed contrast media. ILS may occur in 4% of patients examined in the post-operative phase. Contrast dilution is thus poor radiographic visibility. Water, negative contrast medium. Water is used as a contrast agent in abdominal CT scan to outline the gastrointestinal tract, but it is not used as a contrast agent during fluoroscopic guided contrast procedures. It is called a negative contrast medium. Negative contrast medium that is does not appear hyperdense or white on CT scan as other contrast medium like barium or gastrographin. It appears blackish or hypodense in relation to bowel wall and therefore shows luminal and mucosal abnormality of gut very well. Gases, negative contrast medium. Carbon dioxide and less often air are used in conjunction with barium to achieve a double contrast effect during fluoroscopy guided gastrointestinal contrast procedures. For the upper gastrointestinal tract, carbon dioxide is administered orally in the form of gas producing granules powder. For lower gastrointestinal tract, evaluation is a barium enema. Air is introduced per rectally by rectal tube.